phone was ringing. Somehow I knew the call was for me. Hello?
Alan Wake?
Yes.
Do you know who I am?
No. Who is this?
We'll get to that later. There are spies all over. Shadows.
A sense of deja vu washed over me. Had I had this conversation before?
Alan, listen to me carefully. Caldera Street Station, the subway. You need to go there. I'll call you again later. Make sure to pick up.
Do I know you? I know you from somewhere.
You've just forgotten again. We're in this together. Don't worry. I got you now. We've been working great.
I'm losing you. Hello? Hello? The man had said Caldera Street Station. I had to go there. I had to find the subway station. Caldera Street Station sign was there, but the entrance was missing. I had to make it appear. Maybe I could use the lamp to reveal the station entrance. Was dead in my hand. I needed to find a light for it. It was locked from the other side. Fuck. Okay, don't mind me, just passing through. Shadows stirred like there was someone there, but there was no one. I wanted to keep it that way.
Is this the way it was on the page?
What the hell? Oh, hey. We met at Dorr's show.
Alan Wake, the writer. I'm Alex Casey, looking into a murder.
Come on, what is this?
There's a piece of evidence, a manuscript of a novel. You wouldn't know anything about it?
A manuscript? What manuscript? I need to see it.
Rumor had it the manuscript contained the details of the murders. The murder cult was following the story to commit their gruesome acts. Was Wake their leader? Had he written it? How far would he go to create a perfect work of art? Or would he be the next victim?
This was an echo of the books I had written for years. Picking up Casey's gun felt like I was assuming the role of the detective. I had a light now. I needed to get back to the subway station entrance. Shit. With the alley in darkness now, restless shadows block my way. With the gun and flashlight, I could fight back. I could use the light to open the subway entrance now. I needed to find another light to go deeper inside. I had written books about Alex Casey for years.
Rayan tried to wash away the sins of this city. But some sins, the evidence of the crimes committed, could never be erased. Not by the rain, or any amount of therapy from Dr. Jack Daniels. It remained bruises under my skin, like tattoos. Bruises in my soul. Scar tissue on my heart. The rain never stopped falling. And I never stopped drinking.
There was something hidden here, a phrase repeated over and over. The words resonated with meaning. Had I written this? gates to the platform were closed. I had a ticket. The door was locked. Something about the station platform felt significant. It would work in my writing, but I needed more. Something lingered here. A half-forgotten memory. An echo. Something was here, a vision about to reveal itself. I needed to look at it from the right angle.
Inviting me to draw an obscene picture on the city map. Caldera Street Station. The name made me think of the exit wound of a bullet.
I had a flash of inspiration. The ghost of my fictional detective. A story thread I could use in my writing. I had a location. I had a story thread. I would put them together. Write them into my story to create a path deeper into the dark place. Things clicked into place. The story rang true. I was making progress. The dark place reacted to my story. The way into the tunnels was no longer blocked. The Fed had glimpsed into the maw of darkness. It swallowed him whole. The tracks led into the tunnel. That was my way forward. The blood trail continued deeper into darkness. The tunnels were a maze. The blood trail led me on. another place to use in this story. I needed to search the tunnels for further visions. Inspiration for the story that would lead me deeper. I had a new location for the story. I changed the story. And with that, the dark place changed. Another echo lingered here, a source of inspiration.
Word is, your research can help me, ma'am. What do you know?
There's more than one urban legend about the Cult of the Word. The murder cult used these tunnels for their ritual sacrifices. They say the cult reenacted the murders in Alan Wake's crime books. That Wake was even involved somehow, under a false identity. Mr. Scratch, which is, of course, a nickname for the devil himself.
Alan Wake.
It was disturbing finding myself in the story this way. But I was desperate, and it felt right for the story. The federal agent had come here looking for answers.
The cult can get you anywhere with that.
I had a new beat for the story. I was making my way deeper into the story. I could imagine this murder cult performing their macabre acts beyond the collapsed tunnel. The cultists laid the Casey novel onto the altar with reverence, their twisted Bible.
Shit. Let the day shift handle it. What happened?
I had to be at the scene to see and understand it in order to change it.
Alan Wake.
The water was gone. The way forward was open. Someone was humming. Was it worth the risk to go see who?
Hello.
Oh. Hey, Alan. You snuck up on me.
Sorry. Have we met?
Memory problems again, huh? Yeah, we've met. Tim Breaker. We've shared notes. Hey, I've made some progress on the map, if you want to take a look. I still haven't found my mystery man, though.
Who's this mystery man?
Oh, it wouldn't be much of a mystery if I knew. All I have is a name. Warland Dorr.
The talk show host?
No. No, that doesn't sound like him. The guy has many disguises, but a talk show host? No. I'll keep looking.
You're making a map.
Trying to. It's hard to map a dream, though. I keep ending up in unexpected places. I find interesting things like those strange markings that react to the light, but never the one thing that I'm looking for. Feel free to check the map out. Oh, I've been stockpiling supplies while I poke around. If you find a stash, take anything you need.
I appreciate the help.
Well, that's my crazy wall. I'm just trying to make sense of things. Don't judge me.
I'll trade you walls any day. The train blocked my way forward, but it was here for a reason. It had a role to play. I had found another compelling location to use. Changing a plot element in a scene without being there was impossible.
Anyone there? Dead.
The scene here changed.
This is where the history of the cult gets genuinely disturbing. The cultists track down the torchbearers living in the tunnels. They lock the poor folks up in a derailed subway car, douse it in gasoline. Yeah.
Charming.
It turns into a bit of a ghost story after that. They say the dark smoke from the fire still roams the tunnels searching for new victims to devour.
There are no happy endings in this city.
The story thread felt important. I could use it in one of the scenes I'd found. A sick and twisted story. But it worked. It could not be opened on the side. The subway car had become a burnt husk. I could get through it now. I couldn't add a new element from here. I'd have to go to the scene. was blocked. I had to find a way through. The lights would help me. The Echoing Hall had a story to tell. The new scene I had found was important for the story. Changed into the murder cult's hideout.
This is the ritual to lead you on.
The Fed had witnessed something here that made him run scared. Whether the summoning ritual has been a glorified supernatural event or
rising from the
mass psychosis of stark raving lunatics, it didn't change the facts. The cult was messing with things no one should mess with.
The ritual was a vital part of the story, the key to reaching the murder site. This new plot beat would carry me deeper into the story. This was something out of a horror story, but I had to keep going. couldn't hear the dark presence. It was gone. The tunnel was open now. I could get through. Presence. I had seen it before. I remembered now. It was always out there, hunting me.
Progress, but I'm in danger. The dark presence. Help me. Please, help me.
I could sense it. I was closer to home. Had the woman in the vision helped me somehow? Something had changed outside. Parliament Tower, where I'd lived with Alice. It was out there, waiting for me.